Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, I yield 5 minutes to the gentleman from Texas, Mr. Paul. The
gentleman's recognized for 5 minutes.
I thank the gentleman from Virginia for the time, and I ask unanimous consent to rise and extend my remarks. Mr. Speaker, I rise in opposition to this bill. If ever there were a bill unnecessary, this is one. It is an example of us here in the Congress looking for dragons to slay. This is absolutely unnecessary. There is no real purpose in passing this legislation. As has been said, all 50 states have law against violence and cruelty to animals. That should be adequate. But the way this bill is written really opens up Pandora's box. It's a can of worms. Take, for instance, that it says whoever knowingly possesses a depiction of animal cruelty with the intention of placing that depiction in interstate commerce. Now, that you can get 5 years for. Now, how do you prove intention? I mean, this is subjective, purely subjective. This is not narrowly written. This is very broadly written. So this is a First Amendment concern to many, but it's also so unnecessary. Chief Justice Rehnquist, along with Ed Meese, has stated recently, there's just no need for more federal laws. We don't need more federal laws. We can't even enforce the ones that we have. And besides, this is strictly a state matter. Now, if they want to use the Interstate Commerce Clause, they should be reminded up until this century, at least, the Interstate Commerce Clause was used in its original intent to open up trade between the states. It was never the excuse to regulate everything between the states. So that is a 20th century distortion of the Interstate Commerce Clause. So that's not even a real good excuse for this. Now, cruelty to animals, nobody's going to come and defend cruelty to animals. But quite frankly, there will be times it'll be difficult to define. The motivation for most cruelty to animals is because people are sick. This is a mental illness. We're dealing with mental illness here, and we're going to write a federal law against it. So if somebody, and it was even mentioned by the proponents of this bill, that members like people like Ted Bundy delight in this, yes, these people are psychopaths. They're nuts. It's an illness. We can't pass the law to deal with mental illness. So I strongly object to this approach. We should be thinking not only about the process, but of the unintended consequences of passing legislation like this. I have seen some pretty violent ads against on television of killing cockroaches. I know that is not their intention. I went fishing one time, and it was rather ghastly. I'm not a very good fisherman or a hunter. I can't see the killing of animals. But to see the hook pulled up on a kingfish and have the fish thrown on the deck and the fish suffocate, well, we make movies of this. This is on television. But they say this won't be affected. How do we know? There are hunting films on television. Animals are shot. Maybe people are delighting in looking at these cruelty or the killing of animals on televisions, even though they're sporting and fishing shows. So yes, I agree that is not what is intended. But so often our legislation gets carried away and is misinterpreted. So I would ask my colleagues not to pass this legislation. This legislation does not have any redeeming value whatsoever. It's well intended in the sense that people object to cruelty to animals. But quite frankly, I haven't had one single request from my 595,000 constituents in my district for this bill. And I would like to see how many others who would honestly get up here and say, oh, I have had dozens or hundreds or thousands of people. The only people that I have heard that have requested this piece of legislation are law enforcement officials, not the judges who have to deal with this, not the people in the country, not the state legislative bodies, not the governors, people who may want to have a lot more activity to do things they're not doing well enough anyway. Federal law enforcement is lagging. So to put another law on the books which is not well written, it's subjective in that we have to decide whether or not the person who possesses this material is intending to sell it to somebody. So this bill really is something that we need to just reject, vote down. We don't need it. The states will take care of this. We do not need to be bashful and say that if we don't vote for this bill, for some reason we endorse the idea of animal cruelty. That isn't the case. Nobody endorses this. And I just think that the qualifications in here to exempt certain people, like journalistic and historical and artistic, these categories, quite frankly, who will be the judge? Very difficult to do.
Gentleman from Florida.
I yield 3 minutes to the gentleman from Alabama, Mr. Baucus.